Hey, it's Kaylee. Today, we're going to compare some absolute values on the number line and use our knowledge of inequalities to determine if certain statements are true or false. Let's get to it. So we start out with our number line here, and remember we have our negative numbers to the left of zero. And we have some points on this number line we are going to be interested in today. Now, using these points, let's decide if these two inequalities are true statements or false. Our first one here says A is less than C. Is that true? So first off, we have A here. Where's A? Is that negative 4? So we would say A is negative 4. And then C here, it says less than C. And where is C on our number line? Yeah, we have C over here at positive 4. So we go ahead and write our 4 here. And so that's what that inequality actually looks like when we fill in our numbers. So is that true? Yes, we know negative numbers are less than positive numbers. Easy, right? Okay, next one says the absolute value of A is less than or equal to the absolute value of C. Well, what do you think? True or false? Well, let's plug in those same values. Remember, we knew that A was negative 4, so I'm going to put negative 4 here inside my absolute value brackets, and then I have less than or equal to, and now what was my C? Yeah, my C was normal 4, so I'll have positive 4 in here, and then I need to solve for my absolute values. So the absolute value of negative 4, what's that? The distance to 0 would be just 4 is less than or equal to the absolute value of positive 4 gives me just 4. Now, is that true? Is 4 less than or equal to 4? Yeah, that's true, right? They're equal to each other. So this equal sign right here makes this statement true. Nice work. Now let's try these next two. Our top one says A is less than B. So if we figure out what our A is, remember we saw it over here on our number line, and it is negative 4. So we have negative 4 is less than B. Now where is B? This is going to be the first time we've looked at it. B here is at 1, so I have a 1 here. Now is this true? Is negative 4 less than 1? Oh yeah, negative numbers are always smaller than positive numbers, right? Okay, now how about this next one? The absolute value of A is less than B. So again, I'm going to plug in my A value, which is here at negative 4, into my absolute value. Is the absolute value of negative 4 less than B? Where did I find that? Over at my positive 1. So now here I'm going to solve my absolute value of A. I know the absolute value of negative 4 is 4 because it's just a distance of 4 from 0 is less than my B is 1. So is this true? Is 4 less than 1? I don't think so, right? This statement is false. Nice. Now that we've learned to compare absolute values, we're going to test solutions to absolute value inequalities in the next video. We're really taking it to the next level with our understanding of negative numbers and inequalities, right? Awesome. I'll see you there. Hey, hey.